Hello everybody, today we're going to do a mathematical card trick. So first of all, get your volunteer to shuffle a pack of cards. Then get your volunteer to deal themselves three piles of three cards each. Now you're going to ask them to pick one of the piles. Get them to pick it up and look at the bottom card. Meanwhile, you collect the remaining cards and then get them to put their pile on top. Now, in a minute, you're going to ask them what their chosen card was. But you're going to give them the chance to lie, so they could name any card that they want to. And the pack is going to act as a lie detector. So let's say they name the Ace of Clubs. What you're going to do is you're going to spell out Ace of Clubs. So first of all, you spell out Ace. So it would be A-C-E. Put the pack on top. Now you spell out of, O-F, put the pack on top. And finally, you spell out the suit, so clubs, C-L-U-B-S, put the pack on top. Now we're going to find out if they were telling the truth by spelling truth. So it would be T-R-U-T-H. And the final card was their chosen card. And this will always work. No matter what card your volunteer decides to name, they have a complete free choice, but no matter what card they decide to name, this will always work. Let's see what's going on. The blue card here is their chosen card. The blue card now starts in the third position. So first of all, you start off by spelling out a value. So let's say ace. So it would be A, C, E. Put the pack on top. And the blue card is now in the seventh position. But if your volunteer decides to name something else, so if they name a three, if you spell out something longer, like three, T, H, R, E, E, and put the pack on top, the blue card is still in the seventh position. Next, you spell out of, O, F, put the pack on top, and the blue card is now in the fifth position. Finally, you spell out a suit. So if you spell out clubs, it would be C, L, U, B, S. Put the pack on top and the blue card is in the fifth position again. But if you spell out something longer, like diamonds, if you spell out diamonds and put the pack on top, the blue card will still be in the fifth position. So their chosen card, the blue card, is completely predictable. You always know where it is. And you can finish off the trick by spelling off truth, and that's how you end. Now, what's happening to the other cards? Is the blue card the only predictable card? Well, here are the nine cards. Now, if we start the trick again, the top card becomes the bottom card. The second card becomes the eighth card. The third card becomes the seventh card. Now, if you're spelling out a three-letter word like ace or six, the rest of the shuffle looks like this. If you're spelling out something else, something different, like a four-letter word like jack, then that would look like this. But if you're spelling out a five-letter word like three, then the shuffle would look different again. It would look like this. But the only three cards we know for sure, the only predictable cards, are the first three cards. So let's just concentrate on the first three cards. Now, the second shuffle is always the same. It's spelling out of, O-F. So the second shuffle always looks like this. And then finally, the third shuffle is naming the suit. We can predict the first five cards of that. That's always going to be the same. So the first five cards will look like this. Putting it all together, it looks like this. And if we look at the third card becomes the seventh card. The seventh card becomes the fifth card. And then the fifth card becomes the fifth card again. Now, this is the only complete path from left to right, which means that the third card is the only predictable card. And the other cards really depend on what your volunteer chooses to name. So it's a pretty good trick, it's good fun, and as usual, if you have been, thanks for watching.